It was a scorcher yesterday, so I cranked the air conditioning, but then I started getting chilly, so I got under my electric blanket. There's gotta be a better way to do this. Howdy, domicile dwellers. Trace here for DNews. When you're puttering around the house, you're probably not thinking of melting ice caps or changes in rainfall patterns. You probably just want the temperature right and the lights bright enough to avoid shin-high furniture. And this is a huge challenge for climate scientists. Climate change is such a massive, world-changing issue that it is difficult for any one of us to feel responsible. No raindrop blames itself for the flood. But part of that is putting it in perspective, right? A third of US homes still use coal to generate those kilowatts. 36 states use it either as the main source of power or electricity. According to the US Energy Information Administration, the average consumption for a residential home was about 15,497 kilowatt hours. To generate 1 kilowatt hour with a coal plant requires about 1.04 pounds of coal, which produces 2.13 pounds of CO2. So for every kilowatt hour you can cut, you're saving 2 pounds of harmful greenhouse gas from spilling into our atmosphere, not to mention other pollutants. So if we limit the amount of energy we're wasting at home, we all save money and help the environment. It's a win-win. And there are tons of ways to do this. For example, about 45% of that 15,000 and some kilowatt hours is used for air conditioning, heating, lighting, and water heaters. Obviously, the easiest way to cut your use is to keep the temperature set below 68 in the winter and wear a sweater, or above 78 in the hot summer months and go au naturel. All this will let your home heat itself more efficiently, and it will remove over 1,000 pounds of CO2 from the air annually. Remember when your mom shouted, "Shut the door! You want to heat the whole outdoors?" She's right. But the windows were likely worse culprits. 10 to 25% of all energy lost from a home comes from windows. Simple stuff like using curtains to keep the hot sun out in the summer can make a big difference. Double-paned windows help too, obviously. They have 2 panes of glass with air in between. Believe it or not, air is a poor conductor of heat, so they insulate the house better, like a transparent down jacket. And if you're one of those go big or go home types, look at your light bulbs. Incandescent bulbs waste 90% of the energy it takes to make the light just as heat. Swapping just one for a more efficient alternative reduces greenhouse gases by 400 pounds over that bulb's lifetime. 400 pounds from one measly bulb. There are a couple of choices now to replace them too. There's the crazy spiral tubey ones, which are CFLs, compact fluorescent lamps, and light-emitting diodes, LEDs. If every household in the US swapped out only one of Edison's old school bulbs, that would be the equivalent of taking 800,000 cars off the road. LED bulbs are more expensive, but last 8 to 10 times longer than a CFL and 50 times longer than an old school bulb, and unlike CFLs, LEDs don't use mercury. To put it in perspective, a 100-watt light bulb used for 1,000 hours, or one lifetime, would require 100,000 watt hours, or 100 kilowatt hours. The LED equivalent over that same time would only be 25 kilowatt hours, cutting another 160 pounds of CO2. In the US, the EPA gives appliances an Energy Star label, telling us all how much energy they think that will use in a year. Using efficient appliances and living smartly will save thousands of dollars in energy costs and can cut greenhouse gas emissions by 65 tons per year per person. Helping the planet? It's like putting money back in your wallet, which I kind of love. There are other ways to manage energy usage too. Smart home technology from AT&T Digital Life helps you control your home by adjusting a thermostat, lighting, and so much more, all from your mobile device. I know the internet likes to argue about it, but in the scientific community, there is no contest. Climate change, global warming, it is real. So why is it so hard to get people to care? Part of it is not calling it climate change. I explain why here. Climate change is 20 years older than global warming, though Google's N-grams say they've both hit pretty meteoric popularity since the 1980s. According to Yale's research, though, they're interpreted completely differently by different parts of American society. Let us know what steps you'd like to take to reduce your carbon footprint down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get more DNews, and we'll see you next time.